As shown in the last video, the Bactrian king Euthydemus was defeated by Seleucid emperor Antiochus and was pinned in his fort. In this video, we will continue with the same thread of events. Then, Euthydemus decided to send his son, Demetrius, a young prince at that time, to negotiate peace with the Seleucid emperor. The defeated and the victor were face to face. In the negotiations that followed, Demetrius argued with Antiochus that Euthydemus was not himself a revolter, but had destroyed the ones who revolted against the Seleucids. It was Euthydemus who had overthrown the Diadochid dynasty, which had originally rebelled against and broken away from the Seleucid Empire. Demetrius also asserted that if the Seleucids and the Bactrian Greeks were not allied and instead fought with each other, neither of them would be safe from the nomads from Central Asia. Just like Parthia, other Greek states were also vulnerable to their incursion. Demetrius reasoned that for the betterment of all the civilized Greeks in the region, independence of Bactria was necessary. Antiochus found Demetrius's arguments convincing. He was also already wary of the costly siege against Euthydemus and was eager to end it. Furthermore, he could not afford to be distracted away from the western borders, where Ptolemaic Egypt was hostile to the empire. Finally, Antiochus was convinced. He recognized Bactria as an independent kingdom. Not only that, but he was so impressed by Demetrius's royal demeanor, dignity of his manners, and skill of parleying that Antiochus promised to get one of his daughters married to the prince. Bactria, in return, provided Antiochus with some war elephants that helped him in his later campaigns. A few years later, Demetrius inherited the Greco-Bactrian kingdom from Euthydemus. He proved to be an able ruler, and under him, the kingdom reached its peak. Such was this Bactrian king, allied closely with the mighty Seleucid Empire and ruling a rich and powerful kingdom. He wasn't someone you'd want to be your enemy. But exactly when these events were taking place in the Greek lands, in India, Pushyamitra Shunga had killed the Mauryan emperor and had started persecuting Buddhists. His atrocities even affected the Greeks residing in northwestern border regions of India. And thus, Demetrius had at least three reasons to campaign against Pushyamitra Shunga. First, he had killed and overthrown an ally of the Greeks, Brihadrat Maurya. Second, he was persecuting the Buddhists and was angering the Bactrian Buddhists. And third, he was causing troubles to the Greeks in India. And that is how this remarkable great king, hailing from a rich and mighty kingdom, was now raiding on to India. During his campaign, when Demetrius crossed Indus, he had achieved what no Greek ruler, not even Alexander, had achieved before: conquering Indian land. And that was just the beginning of Greek rule in India. In the next episode, we will see how successful was Demetrius in India, and how did the Greeks rule in India?